The expression jack of all trades, master of none isn't just relevant for people, it also makes sense for vehicles, because when a vehicle is built to do a great number of things, it never really does any one of those things as well as a purpose-built product. This is a purpose-built roadster, the Mercedes AMG SL, and we're going to see how it accomplishes its mission today. At the front, the SL55 looks serious about the task of performance, but in an approachable way. We have the AMG Panamericana grille with the vertical slots, a giant TriStar in the grille, and then another one up on the hood, these angled projector LED headlights with LED DRLs, and then down low, some functional corner vents and a functional front air dam with a gloss black chin splitter. Standing out on the profile are these 20-inch alloy wheels that kind of have a rally-inspired design to them that I'm into, but some people are not, including Phil, who's manning the camera right now. And around those wheels are Michelin Pilot Sport 4S tires, great tires, 265 section in the front and 295 at the rear. Within those wheels are yellow-painted AMG calipers, and moving to the back, we see a V8 bi-turbo badge, just telling you what you've got under the hood, which is a very long hood. That is the style of the Roadster, a long hood, and then this taper to the silhouette. Walking back, we see some flush-mounted door handles and a curve to the rear end that then tucks around the tail with these LED taillights that are nice and thin, and then down low, we've got four darkened exhaust outlets. Also showing right now is the deploying spoiler. And at a certain point in time, the SL had a folding hardtop roof, but now the AMG SL only has a soft top. But you know what? It works with this profile. You can get the AMG SL in three output flavors. The entry-level 43 uses a twin-turbo V6 to make 379 horsepower. This middle child, the SL55, upgrades to a 4-liter twin-turbo V8, making 469 horsepower and 516 pound-feet of torque. But if that's not enough for you, there's the SL63. With the same motor, it makes 577 horsepower. All-wheel drive is standard across the SL range. This one gets to 60 in 3.8 seconds and has fuel economy of 14 mpg in the city, 21 on the highway, and 16 combined. Inside the SL, I'm going to leave the top up just for a sec to show you the headroom situation. This is for myself at 6 feet tall, and clearly I fit with no problem. The rear passengers, it's not going to matter, and I'll show you why in a sec. Now, to put the top down, the vehicle needs to be on, which it is right now. I hit this button here, and then on the screen, you slide your finger to the right for the top to go down, or to the left for the top to go up. Nifty, I suppose, but it kind of takes a while for the screen to boot up to get here, so if you're in a hurry, this could become an irritation. And then holding the slider doesn't really always seem to work perfectly. You have to get your finger just into this right zone. You can't go all the way over to the right. It won't work. You can't go two-thirds of the way. You got to go like 5/6 of the way over to slide it down. But just like that, while I've been talking, the top is down. That took about 15 seconds, and you can do it at speeds up to 37 miles per hour. A ton of stuff comes standard in the SL, including these leather seats with heating, ventilation, and massage, plus air scarves to just brush some warm air on your neck on a cool day with the top down. You also get a standard Burmester surround sound system and wireless charging in here with two USB-C ports and two more USB-Cs in the console. You also get this leather-wrapped steering wheel with perforations at 9 and 3 and a flat bottom. It's got these touch-sensitive controls in the wheel, which work sometimes, but if your hands get clammy at all, then they don't work at all. You have drive mode selectors here that are reconfigurable on the left, a drive mode dial off on the right, and these aluminum paddles on the back, which have really nice travel. They feel great in the hands. You know what? This steering wheel should be heated right now. Hey, Mercedes.
How may I help you?
Heat my steering wheel.
Okay, I'm switching on the steering wheel heating.
That's better. This pair of screens are also standard, a 12.3-inch gauge cluster, which is highly reconfigurable, and then a 12-inch OLED infotainment in this portrait display that is really easy to use, it's vivid, and you don't really have to worry about glare in the SL because you can adjust the angle of this screen to stop the sun from reflecting on it. You're also cocooned in two tones of leather, stitched beautifully on the dashboard in between these very cool air vents. Look like turbines, and they've got ambient light functions to them. The only thing I don't like about this cabin is the use of trim materials. This is a dark gray finish, but it's plastic, and it just shows smudges terribly. That in addition to the gloss black, which collects dust. I think they could just use different materials that won't show those imprints quite as much. And this is a 2+2 setup, but as I said with the headroom, it's not gonna matter because who is going to fit behind me? In the power opening trunk, we find 8 cubic feet of space, but I'm not sure it's long enough to fit a set of golf clubs. That's what the rear seats are for. Now, with this being a purpose-built Roadster, the idea is that you're gonna have the top down a lot of the time, and that's what you wanna do in the SL55. It feels so comfortable like this. The windows go nice and high, and you can install an air curtain back there to cut down the turbulent wind noise. To make this really agreeable, even just around town or going for a nice cruise. And when driven casually, the SL55 is just a peach. The throttle input in comfort is very measured. You gradually work your way up to speed, but there's always enough power to do so. And the brake pedal is easy to modulate, comes smoothly to a stop. And the 9-speed automatic is largely excellent, smoothly getting between the gears. There are only a couple times at low speeds where it'll give you just a bit of a hiccup to upset the calm, the tranquility. And on a bumpier road surface like this, the adaptive dampers are showing off just how sophisticated they are, because instead of being really upset, the chassis is just compliantly working over the imperfections in the road, keeping me quite at ease. But when you arrive at a road that's appropriate, you're gonna wanna turn this dial over here to Sport Plus or even to Race and put your foot down to experience what the SL55 has to offer. Oh, which is for one, a killer soundtrack. And blistering performance. The steering is well weighted and direct. The rear wheel steering system is helping us just turn in to the tight curves. I'm loving that noise and the velocity. And the 9-speed here, holding onto gears so you can stay in the meat of the power band. What a rush this car. The brakes showing off their tenacity, scrubbing that speed. And if you want even greater control over the fun, you can switch to manual mode to operate the paddles, where we find prompt downshifts. And the ability to go all the way out to redline, which is the kind of control as a driver you're looking for. What a day. Now, while the SL is the only exclusive roadster of the vehicles I'm about to mention, it can't exist alone in a silo. It does have competition. The starting price for the SL55 is $138,000. If you want this vehicle as tested, it's a shade under 154 grand. And that sounds like a lot of money, but just wait here. We've got the BMW M8 Competition Convertible. That starts at $145,000, makes 617 horsepower, gets to 60 in 3 seconds flat while getting 18 combined MPG. Or you could have the Porsche 911 Carrera 4 Cabriolet that starts at $136,000 and makes 379 horsepower, gets to 60 in 4.2 seconds while getting 20 combined MPG. Or there's the Aston Martin Vantage Roadster that starts at $158,000. It makes 503 horsepower, gets to 60 in 3.9 seconds while also getting 20 combined MPG. So while the SL55 may not make the most power or be the quickest to 60, it is the second cheapest to start, and I'd say it's probably the best looking of the vehicles I've mentioned. It's also got the best soundtrack, and that's so important as a roadster. The other thing really in this vehicle's favor is how seamlessly it transitions from casual roadster daily driver to a really, really capable performance machine. And that's why I would really strongly consider it if I was shopping this segment. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to learn more about the Mercedes AMG SL or any of the vehicles I mentioned, click the link in the description below. Have a great day. I certainly am. Woo!